Calculating speeds and feeds. So this course contains a bunch of lessons that teach you how to master this calculation. So first of all, we are going to be looking at cutting speed, where we get our cutting speeds from and how we use that data. And then we are going to be looking at cutting times, how we can tell our boss exactly how long our cut is going to take, just by using some simple maths to work this out. We will be looking at feet per revolution, so we can work out what our feed rate should be in conjunction of the spindle speed. And we are going to be looking at feed per tooth for a milling machine. So we can calculate the work that each tooth does. And we can also work backwards by transposing these equations to make other part of the subject. We are looking at spindle speed, how to calculate the correct spindle speed for our CNC mill, and making sure that our spindle speed is not going to be excessive for our cutter and the grade of material our cutter is made from. And we are going to be looking at table feeds, so we can calculate our speeds and feed completely with all of these equations in this course. Now after each lesson, I have supplied some example questions so you can practice the math that we have learned in this course, and that we will be giving you the answer as well, because the most important things here is getting the working out right. It is a resolve to that final answer. Getting the final answer is important, but not as important as the way we get there. Now all the maths in this course I covered both metric and imperial, and the reason of this, to be a machinist we often have to work in both. For example, in the aerospace industry and imperial units used, and in the Airbus industry a metric units used. So quite often we need to work in both and have a full understanding of both metric and imperial. And we might be operating an old machine that only run in imperial, and we might have to convert it for metric. So that is a quick rundown over the content of this online course. So let us start our first lesson. To calculate the spindle speed on the milling machine, we would be looking at spindle speed or revolutions per minute. Before calculation of spindle speed, some short notes of comparable units. Now there are two different ways we can do that. One if we are working in metric, and one if we are working in imperial or English. Now with machines, your both metric and imperial or English is important. Now the maps of both metric and imperial, no matter what you are used to work in. Because if you do change industries, you may find you need to be fluent in the opposite one to watch. You know, so for a good for rounded education in a machine shop, you would need to know metric and imperial or English. And because of that, we are going to discuss both equation. So now I am going to discuss here comparable unit. So there are many units available in both the metric and English systems. In CNC programming, only a very small portion of terms is used. The metric units are based on a millimeter or a meter, depending on the application. The English units are based on inches and feet, again, depending on the application. So common abbreviations for the different units are, so millimeter, mm, meter, m, inch, in, feet, ft. The next table shows the comparable term between the two dimensional system. Older terms are in parentheses. So metric and English. In metric, meter per minute, also written down here mpm. In English, feet per minute, also written down here s or sfpm. Sfpm means surface feet per minute. In metric, millimeter per minute. In English, inch per minute. In metric, millimeter per revolution. In English, inch per revolution. In metric, millimeter per tooth. And in English, inch per tooth. After discussing comparable unit, so now go to define and discuss here the spindle speed. So both types of CNC machine, machining center and lathe, use a spindle rotation when removing excessive material from a part. The rotation may be that of the cutting tool, milling, or the part itself, lathe. In both cases, the activities of the machine, a spindle, and the working feed rate of the cutting tool need to be strictly controlled by the program. This CNC machine required instruction that relate to the selection of a suitable speed of the machine spindle and the cutting feed rate for a given job. So when CNC programming, CNC machining center designate the spindle speed directly in revolution per minute. Programmed spindle speed should be based on the machine material and the cutting tool diameter, so machining center or the part diameter lathe. So at present time we have got to solve here in theoretical problems, but in future so I have got to define how you have to use the machine materials and cutting tool diameter and go to solve in the practical problems. The general rule is that the larger the diameter, the slower the spindle revolution per minute. A spindle speed should never be guessed. It should always be calculated, such as calculations with guarantee that the spindle speed is directly proportional to the programmed. An incorrect spindle speed will have a negative effect on the both the tool and the part. So now come to define mathematical expression about a spindle speed in metric units. So when metric unit system is used in the program, so a revolution per minute will be equal to your 1000 multiple meter per minute divided by pi multiple d. So where revolution per minute is your spindle speed in revolution per minute, 1000 is your multiplying factor, meter to millimeter, meter per minute is peripheral or cutting speed in meter per minute, pi is the constant 3.1415927 and d is the diameter in millimeter, cutter diameter for milling or the part diameter for turning. So now come to the calculate here one problem. So this is my physical problem, so I am not going to relate here as a practical. So giving surface speed is 20 meter per minute and the cutting tool diameter is 15 millimeter. So at present time we have not defined here, so 20 meter per minute, so which material given here in the cutting speed. So simply written down here the given surface speed is 20 meter per minute. So now go to define here. Now put the all values in equations. So revolution per minute is equal to your 1000 multiple 20 divided by 3.1415 multiple 15 will be equal to your 424.42. So go to assume here the 425 revolution per minute. And a short version of the formula is an acceptable alternative and almost as accurate as the precision formula. So you have to use these methods after the experience of 2 to 3 years, then you have directly calculate this process. So revolution per minute is equal to 318.3 multiple meter per minute divided by t. So again, by replacing the constant 318.3 with constant 320 or even 300, the revolution per minute will be somewhat inaccurate but most likely within an acceptable range. In the previous problem, just go to the change here in some inaccurate way. Now so put the value
of your 320 multiple 20 divided by 15, so it will get result is your 426.66, and now the final is your 425 revolution per minute. If you have value given 300 multiple 20 divided by 15, so now you have to get the result 400 revolution per minute. So here is your defining the spindle speed in metric units. The first of all, the theoretical approach, then after go to the approximations, then you have to also use after 2 to 3 year experience in manipulate and calculate in your this manner. So after completion of a spindle speed in metric units, so now I go to the calculate as a mathematical function, so a spindle speed in English units. To calculate the spindle speed in revolution per minute, the peripheral or cutting speed of the material for the cutting tool type must be known, so as well as diameter of the tool or the part. So revolution per minute will be equal to your 12 multiple feet per minute divided by pi multiple d, where revolution per minute equal to your given there a spindle speed in revolutions per minute. So 12 equal to multiplying factor feet to inches. Feet per minute is peripheral or cutting speed in feet per minute. Pi the constant 3.1415927. D is the diameter in inches, cutting diameter for milling and part diameter for turning. Now come to the discuss here one theoretical problem. So not I will go to discuss in the practical. After the completion of the theoretical, then go to the discuss as a practical how to calculate and what is the actual value. So problem is your peripheral speed in the sense of cutting speed for the selected material is 160 feet per minute and the cutting tool diameter is 1.75 inches. So revolution per minute equal to your 12 multiple 160 divided by 3.1415 multiple 1.75. So now come to the calculation. So 349.2417, and now your spindle speed is your 350 revolution per minute. So many programming applications can be used a shorter formula without losing any significant accuracy. So revolution per minute equal to 3.84 multiple of feet per minute divided by d. For less demanding calculations, the 3.82 constant may be rounded to 4 and used as an easier calculations without a calculator. The measuring unit must be applied properly, otherwise the result will not be correct. So again, I will go to define a revolution per minute is equal to 4 multiple 160 divided by 1.75. So 365.71. So your value is your 365 revolution per minute. So never mix English and metric units in the same program. So how to calculate the spindle speed in the theoretical manner? So I have already discussed. So now come to the practical, how do you have to calculate the spindle speed in workshop area, and practically you have to remove the material. So now first of all, this is the very important things is your material machinability. So to calculate a spindle speed, each work material has a suggested machinability rating for a given tool material. This rating either a percentage of some common material such as mandrel steel or a direct rating in term of its peripheral speed or cutting speed or spindle speed. Cutting speed or surface speed is specified in feet per minute in English units and in meter per minute in metric system. The amount of cutting speed or surface speed indicate the level of machining difficulties with a given tool materials. The lower the cutting speed or surface speed, the more difficult it to machine the work material. So cutting speed or surface speed for high speed steel tools will be much lower than those the cobalt based tools and of course of carbide tools. So based on the cutting speed or surface speed and the cutter diameter or the part diameter for lathes, machine spindle speed can be calculated in revolution per minute using the one mathematical formula for English unit system and another when metric unit systems already discussed. So it is the very important points. So cutting speed or surface speed will increase for soft materials and decrease for hard materials. And higher speed steel tools will run slower than carbide tools in the same materials. So the equation to work out our spindle speed in metric would be n equals v multiple 1000 over pi multiple d. Now you may see different figures or different letters in this equation. When I was at college, for example, I was told that 1000 over pi d equals n. So we may see different abbreviation used, but the equation always remain the same. So we are not going to get too confused over our key, but I have included a key here. So the equations I am using now is the way that most machine shops use or most colleges teach using this abbreviation. So our metric equations is n equals v times 1000 over pi d. The equations, if we are working in imperial, is n equals v times 12 over pi d. So n is our spindle speed. This is the number we are trying to work out. This is our revolutions per minute of our spindle that drives our cutter. V is the cutting speed. So don't you confuse in written v in this manner. So r per minute will be equal to 1000 multiple meter per minute divided by pi multiple d. And here is written down n equal to v multiple 1000 divided by pi d. So above revolution per minutes in the written on this process in the very few books, but in the general literacy will be using here in n is equal to v 1000 pi d. And another is an imperial system, revolution per minute is equal to 12 multiple feet per minute divided by pi multiple d. And in the various books are written down here n equal to v multiple 12 divided by pi. So this is the techniques you have to use in the various persons of written down. The most people have used here in the n is equal to 1000 V by pi D and n is equal to 12 V by pi D, which we will discuss in a minute. Now this cutting speed is taken from charts. When I am working in a spindle speeds, of course D is the diameter of the cutter, which would change depends on what cutter we are using for cut. So let us have a look how these equations work and how we can work with this to find out our spindle speed when we know our cutting speed and our torque diameter. So how do we find our cutting speed, which we are calling V for these equations? Well, it is not an exact science. It is depends a lot of their grade of tips we are using on our tools and also many other factors such as a grade of materials we are cutting. The best and most accurate way I found of getting the best cutting speeds by looking on the back of the tooling package you get when you buy your tools. So for example, if you buy Shyam Carbide tips, it will come with recommended cutting speeds on the back of the packet. And if it is does not speak to your tooling rep or to providers to your tips, and they will give you these figures. So cutting speeds are not set in a stone, but there is recommendation. So there is lot of different cutting speed recommendation online, and very rarely they all matches up. But the ones I have taken from a range of source found the minimum and maximum and then given in meridian value of each one. So it gives us a pretty good rough idea on which one to use. So here are splits on cutting speed up into two sections, one in metric and one in imperial. Now the metric ones are meters per minute and the imperial ones are surface feet per minute. So we are going to look at both and we are going to do a calculation that covers both of these. Here we have our different materials and I am going to go with a stainless steel on this one. So meridian value of this would be 15 meters per minute. So we are going to use this value here still our future calculations. Okay, so if our cutting speed is 15 meter per minute, we are just going to make a little note there so we know what our cutting speed is, and then we can start to look at solving our equation here. So we know n is equal to 15 times 1000. Now 1000 is there because that converting it into millimeter per minute, and if we are working in surface feet per minute, and we would times that is 12, and we get solved on the next equation and we divided it by pi d. Now quick notes about pi. I take pi as 3.14. okay, so now the only unknown on our equation is the diameter of the tool. So let us call our tool is a 12 millimeter tool. So that would make the 12 millimeter, so that would be pi times d here. So now this bottom bit here would actually equal 3.14 times, which is 12 millimeter. So that's what our equations now looks like. Okay, alright, so now we can start doing the equations. Find out what n is our spindle speed. So 15 times 1000, well, that is simply 15 with free notes added on the end. So that would be 15,000, and that would be divided by 12 times 3.14, and I am sure we can all do that without calculator. Okay, well, I just use the calculator, and this is 37.68. That is, we come to 398, so we round up to 400. So our answer would be n is still the cutting speed for that would be 15, and our tool would be 12 millimeter diameter. So that is, using a stainless steel and 12 millimeter diameter, we would set our spindle speed on the milling machines to 400 revolution per minute. So now let us have a look at if we are going to work in imperial units. So we take the same calculation, but instead of times that by 1000, we times it by 12. Now also our cutting speed is going to be different, because our cutting speeds will be in imperial and not metric. So let us take a look at our cutting speed again. So if we take the same material, this time still taking a stainless steel, and we are working surface feet per minute this time and not metric. So if we still take the meridian again on a stainless steel, this time we are looking at 50 surface feet per minute, whereas if that was metric before, we ranked in 15. So now we know our cutting speed V, because we are going to be working out this calculation first cutting a stainless steel. So now we can pop over and do our equations again, but this time using 50 surface feet per minute instead of 15 meter per minute, right? So let us draw out our equations. So we have n equals 50 times 12, which will convert it into imperial, and that will be divided by pi, which we are still taking is 3.14, and that would be times our tool diameter. So last time we used 12 millimeter, this times we would be use a cutout pretty much the same size. We can use half an inch of, so as to be 0.7 millimeter larger than the last equation. So half inch would be not 0.5. So these 3-bit decimal lies, any fraction we use in imperial, say 50 times 12, that would be 600, and we would divide by this sum here. So 3.14 times not 0.5 without would be equal 1.57. Now we just did a simple sum here, it's 600 divided by 1.57, and that would equal 382.1. So I told you it is a little bit bigger, only by 0.7 of a millimeter. So we are still getting roughly 400 rpm. So now that comes saying before, the rpm does not have to be exact if we are not hitting those number exact, because back in the day of the manual machining, we could not select exact number. We would have a range of a spindle speed that we can select from. So we can quite happily round this up to 400 revolution per minute and not be too concerned about it affecting the finish or the cut of the parts. So that is the spindle speed calculation in imperial. Let us do a couple more to make sure we really understand this concept. So let us do another metric example, and this time we are going to be cutting aluminium. So the meridian meter per minute for aluminium is 61. So we are going to be using a cutting speed of 61 times this times. Now remember, these numbers are not written in a stone, and they will change depend on the grade of tips that you are using. So always refer back to your providers of your cutting tools to give you an exact cutting speed that they recommended with their tools. And we use the HSS here, by the way, and not carbide for our operation. here. Okay, so aluminium in metric would be 61 meter per minute. So I am just going to our cutting speed is 61. Now as the tool diameter, this times I am going to use a 1 inch diameter tool. Now I know we are working in metric. Say 1 inch would be 25.4 mm, so I am going to pop that in there. So that is the diameter of our tool. So now we just got to calculate our spindle speed. So write down your equation again. We would have in a spindle speed with equal cutting speed b, so that would be 61 and times thousands, and that is all divided by pi, which were taken as 3.14, and that would be times our tool diameter, which is 25.4 mm for an inch cutter. But written that metric has a style. Okay, so now we just have to do these equations again to work out what our n value is. So our spindle speed would be equal to 61. If you times anything by 1000, you just knock off the 1 and add the 0 to the number. It is a quick and easy way of working out what digit is times 2 by 1000. That is what we know is 61,000, and we are going to divide that by 3.14 times 25.4. So for this one, I would definitely needed a calculator, and this comes to 79.756. So n equals 61,000 divided by 79.756. Let us punch that into the calculator and see that our spindle speed recommendations will be. So for cutting aluminium, it gives us a cutting speed of 61 with a 1 inch tool converted into metric is 25.4 mm. Our spindle speed would equal 764.8, so we can round up to 765 without causing any problem. So that is our recommended spindle speed revolutions per minute when we are cutting an aluminium part using the tool diameter 25.4 mm. So let us go through one last final example, and we will do this again in imperial. This times it is important to know how to work in imperial and metric, as we will be using both of these during the course of our career. If we change from one industry to another, we may find if it is the American industry, for example, they may prefer us to use imperial, such as Boeing in aerospace, they still mostly work in imperial units. And if you are still working in the aerospace industry but working for Airbus, they would work in the metric unit. So it is important to know both of these as a machinist. To come back to our cutting speed, so we can find out what V is in our equation here. So we are going to stick with aluminium same as before, but this time we will be using surface feet per minute because we are working in imperial this time. So the meridian surface feet per minute for aluminium, because there is a value of 200, so we are going to be using V equals 200 for this following equations. So I am going to add 200 next to our cutting speed, so we don't forget, and it is time our tool diameter, we can still use 1 inch tool, but because we are working in imperial, we would call it 1 inch and not 25.4 mm, because that would be the metric version. So now we know two parts of our equation. It is easy to work out the third part. So n with equals v, which we just discovered is 200 for aluminium. So let us do these small sums here and see what this equals. Say n equals 200 times 12, so that say I would do this in my head in times 100 by 12. So I was say 100 times 12 is 1200, and it would be 2400. So we are going to be divided that by 3.14, because 3.14 times 1 is 3.14. So if we now do our little division sum there, it will give us our spindle speed n to 2400 divided by 3.14 equals 764.33. So we would round up that up to 765 without any negative consequences, and that gives us the same revolutions per minute as the last equation. So as we can see the matter what we are working in it for working in imperial or metric, we will come to the same revolution per minute roughly. When we are doing these equations using the same information and the same material cutting a speed that we are located. So that is how we work out the rotational speed of our tools in a CNC milling machine. So when we come up with our spindle speed, there is a rough recommendation of a spindle speed we need, but in practice, sometimes we may find materials may need the spindle speed a little bit faster or a little bit slower. So we've tend to use this as a rough guide. We would initially set our spindle speed to this and then speed it up or slow to down depending on the materials cut. So these numbers are generally used as a rough guide in industry, and they are likely, well, this is what the calculations say, that is what the spindle speed must be. But everything has to do with a bit for feel with machine, especially if you come from a manual background, you had understand machine feel a little bit more than a CNC background, because you know that materials has been struggling when you remove in it. You know something do not feel right, it don't quite sound right. So you had slow it down or speed it up and see if it is feels better. So if I tend to use these numbers as a general rule of to give me a starting value, and then from that I would use my own experience as a machinist to either add to them or take them away a little bit to get the shortcut that I require.